So it's not obvious, assuming that you know all of the 555 LTE cases already. So for example, you should know how to solve this with 1L or this case. The first case that I'll be looking at is this inner four cycle parity case. So for this one, you can recognize it as having matched outer wings, and there's a checkerboard pattern here and on the opposite side. This is just the mirror of the previous case, so you have a checkerboard pattern here and a checkerboard pattern here. So for this case corresponds to this L2E case on the 555, which is solved with quite fast to gen out. So for this one, and if you want to do it on the 6x6, you could just replace all the all white moves here with slice moves, but a better way is to just replace only every other move. So we start with a white move here, then do a slice move, white move, slice move, white move, slice move, white move. And you notice that this is completely regripless. If you can do double flicks with your left hand, this is the same thing. White, slice, white, slice, white, slice, white. So after that, we have this slightly advanced fast switch case. Slightly advanced slice with slice case. Sorry, I messed up my words there. And for this one, it's not very obvious that these two cases can both be solved with a single slice with slice each, but they actually can. So for this one, we bring down this middle edge, and we also bring down this outer wing at the same time. Then we do a flip, and this will bring these two over to these positions in the opposite orientation, and they'll be brought back up to match this full edge. And that solves this particular case. And for this case, it's similar. We bring these two down, so normally it will be just executed like that, and we flip this whole group, so we will get these two brought over to this position, and they'll be brought up over here, and they'll complete the edge block. So we can make use of that in conjunction with the inner four cycle L to solve an interesting last edge case. So let me just set it up first. For this one, we have this white parity case and this outer parity case. So you might be tempted to just solve this using two parity outs, but what I've found to be the best way to solve this case is to first do the inner four cycle out, so like this. It sets up to this single slice sub slice case, and you can just cancel straight into it. Yeah. So after that, we have these other inner parity cases that are analogous to the N terms that you see on the 555, like this one and this one. So for these, again, we don't just replace all of the R-white moves with slice moves, but only some of them. So for this one on the right side, and let me demonstrate on the 555 first. This is what the elk I use is. So as I understand it, CubeSkills uses different elks, and different sources will use different elks. So this might not be applicable to the specific elk that you are using, in which case, figure it out on your own. Yeah, this is the one I use for this. And for this case, the L I use is basically just exactly the same except for a difference in the fourth move. This is the only difference. Yeah. So for this, what I do is, well, I already explained it, so let me just do the moves. Oh god, dang it. This is why I don't like the spark. Okay, So this is a white move. Slice. 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 For the other case, it's basically the same thing. Again, there's only a difference in the fourth move. So as you have noticed, there's actually one spot in the algorithm where I do something like this. Yeah, so again. And then